Well, we all know how it goes in the school holidays. Sleepings are suddenly okay, more screen time is kind of inevitable. But as the kids head back to school, it can be tough to break some of those bad bedtime
habits. It sure can. Luckily, sleep expert Dr. Carmel Harrington is here to help. Doctor, good morning to you. Thank you for your time this morning. Look, is it bad to let kids fall out of their regular sleep routine in the school holidays? Because basically, we can't be bothered keeping it to a routine. Mm. And is it even more difficult to get them back into routine afterwards?
Well, the truth of the matter is that the body loves routine. So when you get out of that and you have irregular sleep patterns and waking up later in the day, which is really quite an attractive thing when you're on school holidays, means it is actually sometimes quite hard to get them back into a go-to-school routine. It happens with parents as well, unfortunately.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I mean, that's it, isn't it? I mean, we're sort of all during the school holidays stay up a little bit later, or during holidays stay up a bit later too.
Your little party animals.
Oh, I know. I mean, mind you, my husband and I were both in bed by 7:30 last night.
Same.
And I mean, there's something very exciting about going to bed early, but, you know, we're strange like that. The problem with, like, we found that with the kids and things, like having devices and smartphones and all, do you have much advice as to what to do with the kids in regards to that?
Well, one, we need a routine, right? So to get back into a regular sleep pattern, we really need to be aware of setting guidelines as to what time we go to bed and what time we get up in the morning. And don't change that by more than about an hour, even on weekends, because it will affect our ability to go to sleep that night. As regards to screen use, there's a recent study of over 250,000 8 to 18-year-old Australian children. And what that found was that screen use does decrease your opportunity for sleep, and kids as little as 8 years old were getting not enough sleep because they were using screen. Now, I really want people to understand that children between the ages of 8 and 13 need about 10 hours sleep a night, and children between 13 and 18 need 9 hours. So when they're not getting that, they are and will be sleep deprived and suffer the consequences of sleep deprivation, which will affect their health and mental well-being. And if parents really want to be aware of a child to learn well and think well, you've got to get the sleep that they need.
Mm-hmm. Interesting, with screen time, just really quickly, what are your limits on it, do you reckon?
Yeah, look, we really have to start setting rules around screen time. And one of the things, parents are pretty good at setting rules, but a lot of them don't stick to the rules. So stick to the rules. Maybe have a cupboard where you put your devices when you go to sleep at night. Mm. Children can't access them. Turn off the internet at a set time and have that as a family discussion. Let the people, your children, know. And also set up a nightly routine. So 1 hour before bedtime, switch off those screens, start to have a nightly routine so the body gets to recognise, this is time for me to go to sleep. This is my nurturing and nourishing time. And everyone's level of busyness goes right down, because we live in a very busy world right now.
We sure
and
do.
Our children are busy too.
Thank you so much for your time. Terrific advice there. You
Thanks,
got all that, Alan?
I wrote it all down. It's all in here.